people protesting today?
I'm very concerned about, always been an environmentalist and very concerned about our Southfield environment. I'm appalled that the church would consider drilling for oil on this site, but also I believe this is really incompatible with community living. This is a well-developed area. There are residents, residential neighborhoods all around here, and there are people here in Southfield who get their water out of the ground. We have a number of people that are not on Detroit City Water.
So is there anything that, I know the city has a moratorium in place. Are they not beholden to that, or
well,
why are they continuing?
The state overrules communities all the time.
Yeah. So is there anything that city council can do, or what have you tried to do?
Well, we're just voicing our concern about this, and we hope that the DEQ denies the drilling permit.
Has anyone from the city talked to Reverend Butler or any of the people here?
Yeah, they've been communications with the church and their people, and with the DEQ, and with Jordan Development. Jordan Development, the drill, the company that would do the drilling, thinks this is perfectly safe. And the church says this will be good for the community.
And take your toxins with you!
How long have you lived in Southfield for?
Since 1983.
And why are you out here today?
Protesting against the madness of drilling here in this area.
Why do you consider it madness?
Because it's, number one, it's going to take down the value of my property. Two, it's going to affect the environment. And I live here, I would like to have the same lifestyle that I have when I move, not what they're going to have on me.
And you have a forum coming up about fracking here in Southfield, right? Can you
That's
talk
right.
a little about that?
We're going to be hosting a town hall on January 27th at 6 p.m. That's a Wednesday night at the Southfield Library with our Water Resource Commissioner, Jim Nash, to talk about oil and gas drilling, as this obviously has become a hot topic here in Southfield, and its implications on our health, on our environment. And in conjunction with that, we're also doing a supply drive for Flint, which has obviously faced toxins in its water. We're doing a bottle water drive, a jug of water drive, and one thing that's actually needed too is ready-to-serve baby formula that does not need water to be mixed in it. So those we're doing a supply drive in conjunction with our town hall on the 27th.
So what is happening at the state level around the issue of fracking?
So the DEQ right now is considering this particular application for oil and gas exploratory drilling in Southfield. I've expressed to them my opposition to this permit, as has all city officials, including our city attorney. The city of Southfield has a moratorium on oil and gas drilling in the city of Southfield, which the state is not respecting, and that's not right. So as we return and resume session in this new year in Lansing, I'm going to introduce legislation that addresses two things. Number one, bans the practice of drilling in dense populated areas such as Southfield, and number two, compels the DEQ to respect local ordinances as it pertains to oil and gas drilling in the community.
Now, you live in Southfield, correct?
I live right up the road, a mile away from here.
So how could this affect you if it goes through?
I think the most important thing is we don't know. We don't know how it's going to impact our quality of life. We haven't done enough digging on what oil and gas drilling does to our health and its implications when it's this close to a populated neighborhood. There's a neighborhood that abuts this property right next to it that's been fully developed here in Southfield. I'm here with Mayor Siver, and when we were on the city council, we sounded the early alarm. farm. And we passed a resolution back in 2012 to the DEQ to examine the health and environmental impacts on fracking and gas and oil drilling this close to populated neighborhoods. So the fact of the matter is we haven't had all the information that we need, which is why we need to take a breath and take a pause on what's going on here in Southfield.
Is there anything else you think the public should know?
Come to my town hall on the 27th and find out more, because if it can happen here, it can happen in your backyard too.